Hey everyone, and welcome to World Heritage Journey, where today we're at the rock engravings of Tanum, southwest Sweden. So today we're on the coast of southwestern Sweden looking at rock engravings that date from the Bronze Age, around 1500 to 500 BC. They're all done in these huge granite rocks that were originally on the shoreline, though as the oceans have retreated, they've ended up on top of hills. Now there's a huge variety of stuff to see, so let's have a look. So although there's around 500 of these sites dotted around the area, this is one of the most famous, and it's known as Vidlika. And on this rock, we can see a huge variety of stuff. There's people, boats, animals, gods. There's just so much to unpack here. It's really, really cool. The best known carving here is one known as the bridal couple, and it's a man and a woman that look like they're getting married, though it's probably a fertility ritual, perhaps involving gods of some sort. You can also see naval battles. There's guys in ships, axes raised, and it's really, really evocative. There's also a beautiful depiction of a blue whale. So this is the second site we're looking at, and it's known as Asperberge. Now you can really see here the smooth granite face of the rock, and it was worn down by retreating ice caps after the last ice age. And the engravings are actually really shallow, they're only a few millimeters deep. The painting as well that you can see, the red coloring, that's actually not original. That's been added later by museum workers and so on, because it's not actually known if the original engravings were painted or not. So behind me, you can actually see what one of the unpainted carvings looks like. And this one is a horse dating from around 500 BC, which actually makes it one of the newer ones here. And although it's a very controversial practice, the painting of the carvings, it certainly helps us quite a lot because, yeah, you can't really see it from here. And so this is the final place we're looking at, an area known as Litslaby. And it's dominated, as you can see, by an enormous carving of the Norse god Odin. It's 2.3 meters in length, and he's wielding an enormous javelin, and it's carved directly over the top of some other carvings of animals and boats. And I think it's a really good place to end because there's a nice variety here, and it really shows you how the carvings cover both practical and transcendental things, I think, because you see things like boats and plows and everyday life, and then you also see gods and rituals and stuff like that, which I find fascinating, and it's a real insight into a culture I don't know a whole lot about. But that's it from me. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I'm Joel on the road, and I'll see you at the next World Heritage site.